Yo
and
All right, Shalom. First and foremost, I'd like to give all praise, honor, and glory unto Yahweh, Bahashem, Yahusha, Bahashem, Rakakwadash, double honor to the apostles and elders, GMS, rule well, teach well, being great example to us younger brothers, and peace and blessing, salutation to the hopeful lake out there pushing his word and truth and in sincerity across the four winds in the name of Yahweh, Bahashem, Yahusha, pushing to get up out of here. Shalom to the hopeful lake, the believers, the listeners that have came back to the obedience. All right, of the scriptures through faith in Yahweh Bashim Al-Shah. All right, just want to come with another, news and prophecy update, dealing with the increase in violence, that we see going on in the earth, and the current rulership, has the planet earth in complete chaos, man. There's a very wicked, demonic, warlike, energy that's in the earth, and as we see, these people have gotten, that potion, we're seeing a lot of behavior changes, man, and this man, all right, is heavy into his enchantments. The scripture said, in the latter days that he would try to stand, all right, he would try to extend his rulership through enchantments, man, so we know there's heavy, demonic, off, warlike vibration that's going on in the earth, man, and this man has to be rooted out the way, because I'm out here now, just looking at, just in the, it's out here in this park, over here by a lake, and it's just so tranquil, peaceful. You see, you got shaded areas, man, and just, you can hear the sounds of nature, But then you go out into the earth, it's chaos, man, because of this man, you see, and under the rulership, all right, it'll be Hawasha and that governing body. All right, the earth will get back to peace. You see? Matter of fact, let me start with that. And then we get that in Matthew. Then I got some articles I wanted to go into. Now, when you get Proverbs 29, all right, and 2, it says, when the righteous are in authority, the people rejoice. Yeah, hey, because just, as we went into yesterday, all right, dealing with what? Let's get that in. The wisdom of Solomon, and the earth is crying out for new rulership. They just don't understand, what a righteous rulership is. You see, this is on Wisdom of Solomon 6:24. It said, but the multitude of the wise, and that's ultimately talking about the governing body of Israel. All right, that's going to be the multitude, all right, of wisdom in the earth. All right, Yahusha, that governing body, the house of David, King David, being one of the heads under Yahusha, that will be the supreme wisdom, all right, in the earth, the supreme wisdom in existence that's going to rule in righteousness, that's going to restore, all right, order in the earth, man. You see, it says, but the multitude of the wise is the welfare of the world, and a wise king is the upholding of his people. You see, and the condition of the planet earth lets you know that we're under an unwise king, you see. So when you go to Proverbs, all right, Proverbs 29:2, it says, when the righteous are in authority, the people rejoice. When the wicked bear rule, the people mourn. And right now we're seeing a heavy case of mourning, all right, and it doesn't just mean, shedding tears, man, people are mourning through violence, protesting, rioting, all type of things, man, and the earth is in chaos because of the rulers, man, all right, and Yahusha spoke of these things because Yahusha didn't give us a specific date of his return, but he left us signs, all right, he left us signs to gauge, how close he was to coming back, he talked about different scenarios that would be going on. Now, when you go to Matthew 24:12, and it says, and because iniquity shall abound, and iniquity, all right, is sin, you know, and this rulership is this, you know, this society is ran by the man of sin, Esau, Edom. All right. Now, when you go into that word iniquity in Greek,
Anomia.
All right. It said the condition of without law. And what law is it speaking of? The law of the scriptures. You see? And this society is very anti-Messiah. You know? And the main ones that's supposed to be upholding the righteous standard of the Bible, you Christians, you know, you hate the law more than anyone. You know? But we know Esau Edom is completely adverse, all right, to the standard of the scriptures, man. And he has influenced the planet Earth in that same wicked mindset, man. You see? So this is a society that's void of a righteous standard. And what's the result of that? All right? It says, and because iniquity shall abound, the love of many shall wax cold. And that's what we're seeing happening in the earth. Now, I want to get some articles. Now, we know, you know, there are things, you know, some things are hoax. You know, some things are false flags, you know, fabricated. But some of these things are real, man. You know, people bugging out, man. You know, these people are under heavy enchantments. All right. So it says 4 mass shootings in 6 hours leave 38 wounded and 6 dead. And this is from ABC News. I'm going to play the clip. We'll see if it'll play.
One of my favorite posts of working with young my dad, the clubs, and I'm part of the group.
Damn.
And people with the believers working together with everybody, same opportunities. I want to create a more inclusive and acceptable world for you, and you.
This is the condition of the earth, man. You know, just as you can see, just random acts of violence, man. It's a very, you know, violent energy in the earth. All right. And it says at least 4 major U.S. cities were reeling from an onslaught of mass shooting over the weekend that left at least 38 people wounded, 6 dead. Police officials alarmed that the surge in gun violence is a prelude to a bloody summer. All right, hey, so they're already pushing the narrative of a bloody summer, you know. Then you got the new Purge movie is coming out, you know, Purge Forever, Forever Purge, if I'm saying it right, you know. Look at the timing of these things, man, because we know the elites want chaos, but chaos is prophesied, man, you know. And it says, as the nation emerges from the pandemic, police in Austin, Cleveland, Chicago, and Savannah were all investigating on Sunday mass shooting that erupted over a 6-hour streak that began around 9 p.m. on Friday and spilled over into Saturday morning. It was disturbing what we're seeing, the country, and the level of gun violence that we're seeing across the country. it's disturbing and it's senseless. Savannah Police and Chief Roy, Police Chief Roy Minter Jr. said at a weekend news conference after one person was killed and eight others, including an 8-month-old baby and two teenagers, were wounded. All right. It says on Sunday morning, Savannah Police were working to identify the suspects or suspects who rolled up in a dark-colored sedan and unleashed a barrage of gunfire around 9 p.m. Friday on a group of people standing in front of a home in a residential neighborhood of East Savannah. Mentor identified 20-year-old men killed in the ambush as Arthur Milton of Savannah. You know? So it just, you know, violence after violence, man. And this is the norm. This is the norm that you people, you know, want to get back to, man. All right. Now you read down. It said the Gun Violence Archive, an online site that tracks shooters across the country, reports that there have been 270 mass shootings in 2021. All right. The site defines mass shooting as single incidents in which four or more people are shot, regardless of whether anyone dies, man. So 270 mass shootings so far in these first 7 months, man. And why is that, man? Because who's ruling the earth, man? What do the scriptures say? You know, when you go to Sirach 10:2, it says, as the judge of the people is himself, so are his officers. And what manner of man the ruler of the city is, such are all they that dwell therein. All right, Esau Edom is the biggest thug. He's the violent man. You know, he was sent here to destroy. All right. And the way this man runs his society, it makes it convenient for these things to happen, man. Look at all the guns he has in the market, how accessible, you know, guns are, man. You know, guns getting dropped off in neighborhoods. And, you know, look how this man runs his society, man. Verse 3, it says, an unwise king destroyed his people. That's what we're seeing. An unwise king, Esau Edom, that destroyed his own people, man. You know? It says, an unwise king, all right, destroyed his people, but through the prudence of them which are in authority, the city shall be inhabited. And that's going to be under the rulership of Yahushua, man. You know, we're going to see the earth flourish, all right? And even after that 1,000 years of rigorous captivity for these heathens, and after Esau was done away with, because the energy he brings to the earth will not be needed, all right, within our kingdom once it's established, man. You know, but the nations will be able to enjoy, all right, a righteous kingdom. You know, they won't have immortality. They won't have the status that we have. They won't have access, you know, to the powers that we have. They won't have access to the earth, all right, other planets as we have, you know. But they will enjoy, all right, a righteous rulership, you know. They will get to enjoy, all right, the benefits of the earth giving forth its strength, man. You know? So let's go to Psalms 140:1. It says, deliver me, O Lord Yahweh, from the evil man. Preserve me from the violent man. And this is the man that's in rulership, which imagine mischiefs in their heart and their mind. All right? And it says, continually are they gathered together for war. Yeah, and this man and his rulership, all right, has constantly been at war. And not only has he been at war himself, but he has turned everything at war with each other, man. All right? Everything is at war with each other, man. You know, man and woman are at war. The children and parents at war. All right? you know, all these different nations are at war. You see? And he's the source of it, man. He's the source of all this that we see in the earth, man. The earth is at war with the inhabitants, man. Everything's at war under this man's rulership, man. All right? So let's go from there. Got another article. All right? Now, another one from CNN, and it says one dead and two injured after dispute over mask at grocery store, sheriff says. All right, So you had an argument about a mask that led to a shootout, man. And before we even read this article, you know, because just overall in general, because a lot of these, you know, some of these shootings just happened, you know, at downtown areas of the entertainment districts of these different cities, you know, especially brothers and sisters that's in these big cities, you know, be mindful as you move about, you know, as you're out and about, you know, be mindful, you know, be very, you know, circumspect in these times as the scriptures, you know, promote, all right? This is Ephesians 5 and 15. It says, see then that ye walk circumspectly, not as fools, but as wise. Yeah, and we should be very circumspect in this time and apply wisdom, moving wisdom, man. You know, if it don't feel right, you know, keep it moving. You know, like if the energy off, you know, like we gotta learn how to pick up on particular things, man. You know, brothers, be wise, man. You know, dealing with women out here, man. You know, you brothers, you know, be wise out here, be circumspect. We come to some time where a lot of people gonna be desperate, man. You know, everything seems like it's peachy right now, you know, but we have to remember what times we are in, you see. So just be very circumspect. Places, you know, where you see somebody arguing, you know, hey, it's time to, you know, move around. You know, especially these people, you know, arguing about these masks, because you got the pro mask, the anti-mask, the pro max, the anti-maxine. So, you know, it's a lot of division out here, man. People are tense. You know, people are frustrated with these different restrictions, and people have lost businesses. And, you know, it's a lot of tension. You know, it's a lot of tension out here. So, brothers and sisters, be wise, man, how you move, you know. And dealing with these masks. You know, I rarely wear one, you know, but I keep one with me just in case, you know, one of these people, you know, if I make Kroger or something, they say I have to wear, you know, I put it on, you know, handle my business and get out of there, you know. But if they don't say nothing, I don't wear them. You know, I try to wear them less as possible because I know, all right, this is nothing but, you know, really just suffocating you, man, you know, screwing your immune system, you see. But, you know, if you're asked to wear one and you're out, you know, I know different cities, different states, they got different guidelines about the mask, you know. But if you're out, you know, just be mindful, all right, to comply, you know, when asked to comply, you know, don't be out here arguing, you know, about no mask, man, no damn mask, you know. I say wear them as less as possible if you can, you know, but comply, you know, when you have to. You know, it says on one dead, two injured after dispute over masks at Georgia grocery store, sheriff says. It says a dispute over a mask Monday at a grocery store led to a shootout that left an employee dead and two people, including a sheriff deputy, injured, according to DeKalb County Sheriff Melody Maddox. The suspect entered the Big Bear supermarket at South DeKalb Mall in Decatur in the Atlanta metro area, where there was an argument with the cashier over a mask. Maddox gave few details about the argument but said it was over a face mask. The suspect then shot the employee and she died from her injuries, Maddox said at a news conference Monday. You know, and another thing, like, you know, you brothers and sisters, you might work somewhere, you know, where they tell you to enforce, you know, this mask policy. All right, be wise. You know, you see somebody getting hostile, you know, go get the higher ups, man. You know, when you're not, you know, putting our life on the line to make people wear masks. Now, you got to do your job, you know. For the most part, you might mention it and people comply, you know. But if you see someone getting hostile, you know, I wouldn't put my life on the line about no damn mask. You know, I go get the higher ups, you know. So just be mindful, all right, in these situations. You know, it says a reserve deputy working security at the store fired at the suspect who returned fire. Both were injured and taken to local hospital. Maddox said the reserve deputy was a 30-year-old veteran, all right, of the force prior to retiring and joining the reserve unit. He is in stable condition. The Georgia Bureau of Investigation in DeKalb County, all right, police are investigating the incident. Yeah, so... this is what you got, man. you know, over a mask, man. An all-out shootout, you know, over a mask. You see? But this is where people live, man. People are on edge, man. You know? These people are on edge, man. You know? So as we end it here, all right, with 2 Timothy, all right, chapter 3, it says, "This know that in the last days perilous times shall come." And you go in the time perilous, all right, because it's going to continue to get worse and worse, all right, perilous. All right, and it says the Greek.
Strong's G5467. Chalipas. Chalipas.
Chalipas. All right, it says hard to do, to take, to approach. Yeah, because it's hard times, man. You know, hard to bear, troublesome, dangerous, harsh, fierce, or savage. And this the times that we coming into, man. All right, some harsh, fierce, savage-like times, man. Everyone is going to be out for their own gain. All right. Everyone is going to be all about self. You see? And it's going to be a very primitive mind state that's going to kick in, man. And these people are under heavy enchantments, man. People on all these different medications and, you know, prescriptions, you know? It's going to be a very demonic, you know, dangerous time in the earth, man. And that's why we pray to be shielded from on high. You know, because that's the only way to be preserved from the chaos that's finna be brought to the earth, man. And ultimately, Yahweh Bashima Al-Shai that's bringing it, man. Who's pushing the earth into pandemonium, man. You know, an all-out demonic, you know, savage, you know. Just all, you know, wilding out, man. So, you know, I just want to bring that out, you know, and just to let you know, what is this? This is flood behavior. All right, this is nothing but more flood behavior. Genesis 6 and six and 11 said the earth was also corrupt before the Most High, and the earth was filled with violence. And the Most High looked upon the earth and beheld it was corrupt, for all flesh had corrupted his way upon earth. You see, so the Lord is looking at earth, you know, just as he's looking at it right before the flood, right before Solomon and Gomorrah, and the earth is in that same condition, man. And we're about to see that great judgment go forth from on high, man. You know, so I just want to bring that out. You know, Lord will, you know, you brothers and sisters, you know, we're edified until next time I say Shalom.